Hello everyone. Today I'm going to talk to you about our work, Continual Self-Training with Bootstrap Remixing for Speech Enhancement Problems. This is a joint work with Yossi Adi, Vamsi Ithapu, Buyeksu, and Anurag Kumar. So single channel speech enhancement is effectively a source operation problem where one wants to extract the speech target from a mixture of sounds. And instead of the R systems, source operation systems look like this, where they operate on spectrogram-like representations and they optimize time domain loss. So the problem with all those systems is that they need lots and lots of supervised in-domain data to train on. And of course, as you can imagine, it's almost impossible to gather clean ground truth source waveforms for real-world mixtures. So the goal is to leverage in the wild mixture data in order to be able to scale to mismatch environmental conditions, such as different input signal to noise ratios, different noise sources, speakers, etc. And we need all that in order to make speech denoising systems universal, in order to work with any headset and any phone and any environment, and also make realistic and more immersive audio virtual reality environments. In a conventional supervised training recipe, we synthetically generate mixtures by mixing a clean speech sample and a clean noise waveform. We let the supervised model estimate the sources here and regress over the targets. Mixture environment training is a self-supervised approach for source operation where it synthetically generate mixtures of mixtures. In the speech enhancement case, we synthetically mix a noisy speech sample with a clean noise waveform, and we let the model estimate all of the sources here, and we assign the sources back to the input mixtures. And here we can also optionally inject some extra noise, but this, as we will see, leads to poor out-of-domain generalization to unseen mixtures, and this problem comes in because effectively we don't know if the noise sources, the noise dataset in hand, closely captures the real noise distribution over here. And also this artificial mixing process, it's artificially changing the input mixture distribution. And we see here that as long as you have in-domain or similar to in-domain noise, you do quite well, closely matching the supervised performance. But once you go to a slightly mismatched out of domain data set, the performance drop significantly. So what we propose, we call our method RemixIT, is that we bootstrap the remixing process using a student teacher framework. And we continually refine the teacher estimates to make the student even better. Without the need of in-domain waveforms, neither speech or noise. So RemixIT in a nutshell starts from a noise speech dataset where we grab a batch of mixtures, as we see here, and noise mixtures. We have a pre-trained teacher on some kind of out-of-domain data, could be mixed, supervised teacher on some out-of-domain data, and we estimate the teacher noise estimates and the speech estimates. And by the way, we can also optimize, fine-tune this alongside the whole network, but we saw that in our experiments that it's enough to just keep it frozen. And we use the teacher speech estimates alongside the permuted noise estimates now. So we take the noise estimates and we permute them. We generate new bootstrap mixtures by remixing them together, as we see here, and we feed those bootstrap mixtures to the student model that estimates some noise estimates and some speech estimates, and uses the teacher's permuted sources as pseudo-targets. One more aspect is that we can refine the teacher estimates over different rounds, over different optimization steps by using a sequentially updated teacher or a running mean updated teacher protocol using the latest student's weights. In our experiments, we use a variety of data collections, including the DNS challenge and LibreFSD50K, which are fairly large and diverse. We also use WAM as an example of a really mismatched scenario where we have two noise sources per mixture and a very restrictive set of noise class of urban sounds. And also we use VCDK. So we see here that we use as a separation model the pseudo-MRF, which is able to obtain state-of-the-art results for source separation problems with much less memory requirements and much less latency by using also mixture consistency at the output. As a time domain loss, we use the scale invariant signal to distortion ratio with equal weight for the noise and the speech slots. In our experiments, we see that we can perform self-supervised training starting from a pre-trained mixed model trained on some kind of out-of-domain data. And in this case, it's important to understand that we use knowing domain clean noise recordings. We can also use the same R method for performing semi-supervised domain adaptation, where we start from an out-of-domain supervised teacher, but on other data. And we can update this teacher gradually and refine its estimates. And as a last experiment, we can perform zero-shot domain adaptation using exponential moving average teacher, where the goal is now is to fine-tune our model, our student model, but we don't have lots of mixtures to leverage. So we want a slightly different approach for a low resource data set. For some experiments show that we have a consistent improvement when we use mixed over the teacher model, as we see here. And this holds for supervised teachers and the mixed teachers. When we go from the LibreFSD 50K to the DNS challenge. Another important aspect is that we close the performance gap when we use our method between the self-supervised methods and the state-of-the-art number, which is obtained by using supervised in-domain training. And going back to the comparison with Mixit, we see that although Remixit does not use any in-domain data, as we see here, so it does not use any in-domain DNS data, it is able to yield a significant improvement over the previous state of the art self-supervised method. Another interesting aspect is that by using this kind of sequential teacher update, we can also make the student gradually deeper and deeper, so even more expressive. And we see that we can continue to learn better by instead of having like a static teacher and student with a static number of processing blocks. So replacing the old teacher with the later student weights is really important to obtain better results doing like a completely self-supervised training method. For the last experiments, we say that we can perform zero-shot domain adaptation at different adaptation test datasets. And we see that Remix shows significant improvements against all of the teacher models that we use here, which is like cross domain. And this also holds for really challenging zero-shot learning setups, such as the DNS challenge test set, where we only have like 150 mixtures, so a really low resource data set. And also in cases we have a great mismatch between training and the adaptation, such as one. Some more experiments, which we invite you to see in our longer version of the paper, which is available online, is how well we can use self-supervision for performing target domain speech enhancement and also cross-domain generalization. And we see here when we go from the LibreFSD 50K to the DNS challenge, RemixIT yields an improvement of around 1.5 dB for your target domain numbers. But it is quite significant that we can obtain a really, really good 6.3 improvement on cross-domain generalization, even with slightly mismatched noise distributions between the LibreFSD 50K and the DNS challenge. So this problem becomes even harder for RemixIT when we use severe noise mismatch cases, such as going from LibreFSD 50K to WAM, which has a different set of noise sources active and also a different set of types of noises. And we see here that RemixIT obtains almost similar results as before, like with some performance hit, but even better in most of the cases for compared to in-domain self-supervised training of RemixIT. Well, RemixIT totally fails to generalize to severe mismatched data. And there is a reason for all that, because RemixIT is able to learn robustly under expectation. And if you take a loss which minimizes the L2 norm of the error, you can see that you end up having like three terms, which is effectively the supervised loss of the student, assuming that we had access to the clean speech, which we don't have. Something which is constant and we don't care about, and also an error correlation between the student and the teacher estimate with respect to the same ground truth source. So if you analyze the latter term, you end up having an empirical mean student error here. So effectively is that you mixed almost the same clean source under a different noise source distribution. So by creating these bootstrap mixtures, as we see here from 1 to 64, we see how we obtain a really big improvement, even in cases where your teacher does not perform a good estimate at all. So we can perform better and better. And a final cool aspect for all that is that you can also perform RemixIT with around 30 lines of code, which is actually that I fitted here. So this is a perfectly working PyTorch loop that you can use for your experiments and make your speech enhancement models better if you're interested in. In order to conclude, RemixIT is the first speech enhancement method which works completely self-supervised without the need of a single in-domain waveform. It also outperforms previous state-of-the-art methods which require in-domain data and helps significantly with cross-domain generalization, which is really important. Also, can be used seamlessly for semi-supervised domain adaptation and zero-shot learning when we have like a low resource data set. RemixIT treats the training method as a lifelong process and is based on bootstrapping the mixing process like here. Iteratively refine the estimates of the teacher and robustly learn under really noisy estimates. RemixIT can also be paired, as we said, with end-to-end training of this teacher, and people have used RemixIT for more general source suppression problems. And we can also make RemixIT better by using a confidence-based measure to refine the teacher estimates. So I would like to thank you all for attending this talk and watching the video. We're looking forward to meeting everybody in the Q&A session. And we welcome you to see the longer version of our paper, which is available online. Thank you very much.